The sun falling in.
It's true. It's nice and cool today.
Let's bring some sunshine back. In spirit.
I am begging for your favor.
that all of you are somewhat familiar with this very famous song, but maybe not as familiar with its backstory. It was originally written completely in Yiddish, which was deemed as a little bit too racy at the time. And so Sammy Cohen made a compromise and said, okay, let's keep the title by Mirvis Duchesne. And the Andrew sisters went for it, they recorded it, and it became their first hit in 1938.
That's a good mention. Thank you all so very much. So we love to sing as a trio and three-part harmony, but we also like to feature each of our individual voices. So we're going to do some solos for you now before coming all back together as a little sisterhood. And first up is going to be the beautiful Grace.
Choo-choo train. Pardon me, boy, is that the train of your choo-choo? Track 29. Boy, you can give me a shine. I can afford to board the train of your choo-choo.
When all the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found.
Yeah.
music. Now, this next song we've got is absolutely a toe-tapping, dancing song. So if anyone feels like shaking a leg, doing a little dance, we have some room down right here in front and on the sides. This is definitely the song we're doing.
You got to do some dancing to get in the mood. Mister, what you call him, that's a kindly idea. Something singadilla would be good to my ear. Everybody must agree that dancing has charms. When you help a certain one you love in your arms, stepping out with you would be a sweet interlude. A builder of without a word, me in the mood.
Of the armed forces with our military medley. So when you hear your tune, if you or a loved one has served in the armed forces, raise a hand, stand up. We would like to honor each and every one of you.
Army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fighting till the battle's won. And the army
originally were going to record this song, they couldn't because all of the musicians were on strike. And luckily, the putting off of the recording of the song made it just right for Doris Day because it coincided with the end of the war, making it the unofficial welcome home song.
Les Brown and his band of renown, a Pennsylvania native himself, made this song famous just as the war was ending.
Thank you.
you're in for a treat next, because the beautiful Teresa Eamon is going to prune for you.
I need a 50.